Hey guys, what's going on? DuffKing56 here, back in the Fallout world. Welcome back to Fallout New Vegas Let's Play. I kind of want to talk to Miss Trudy. See, I really want to know what is up with this Ringo guy. Sorry, this hasn't been like a really engaging introduction, but seriously, I'm kind of interested because this is kind of where I left off. So I'm kind of want to figure it out.
Don't know why you want to do a thing like that. Yep, you'd get on their good side, but people around here wouldn't appreciate it one bit.
Okay, so I mean, I guess that's it. I mean, I kind of want to rescue him. Thank you for telling me to be careful. I appreciate the thought, but let's get out of here. We can either kind of explore a little bit or hop right on the road to go through the main quest line and start it. But from what I've heard, that the more main questing you do before you actually side quest, it really throws you into the meat of the game. So I might want to spend some time looking for some side quests, talking to people, figuring out more about New Vegas and such. So, you know, I guess we'll figure it out in the end, but let's actually see. Oh, that's the wrong button. Pardon me for not knowing anything. Okay, it's B button here. I kind of want to figure out what kind of quests I have right here. So we got to Ghost Town Gunfire, which I think isn't main quest. They want that away as the main quest, I believe. And Prim is the town that we're going to. So I think we're going to try to help out this Ringo character with Ghost Town Gunfight. So let's actually go head out there right now and see what he has to say. They said he's holed up in the gas station, I believe, hiding from the NCR, I believe, which were the people, if you don't remember, were arguing with her in the saloon and broke her radio, which we then later fixed. Let's go talk to Ringo. See if we can get some good experience from him and see if we can help him out, man, because it kind of sucks that he's getting chased, and I think it would be worth our wait to help him out. So there we go. Take some Sunset Sarsaparilla and go through here. He's inside, I'm sure, just hiding away. I want to see if there's anything around back here, though, just in case. I learned my lesson, you know, from other games where scavenging is important, that you should definitely look anywhere. So let's go into the gas station here. If you can realize, though, now the loading screens are much quicker because I installed the game to my hard drive. I'm very excited.
That's close enough. Who are you? What do you want with me?
Whoa, dude, it's okay. I'm not an enemy, if that's what you're asking. I'm just having a look around. Okay, I'm not an enemy, if that's what you're asking.
Sorry about the gun. You just caught me off guard, that's all. We got off to a bad start. What say we start over with a friendly game of Caravan? You know how to play?
No, I don't know how to play freaking Caravan. Although, I think a bunch of people do tell you all about Caravan. Did you know there's a man named Joe Cobb looking for you?
Yeah. He doesn't look very tough, though. I hear he's afraid I'll shoot him down from one of the windows when I see him. And he's right. I'll have a much bigger problem once his friends show up. There's no way I could handle all of them in a gunfight.
Very interesting. Oh, it might have been the Powder Gangers that we're looking for. Maybe not the NCR. The guy looked like he was NCR, though. So why are the Power Gangers? I'm kind of curious, like I said, why are the Power Gangers out to get you?
My caravan was on the return trip from California and heading back to the company branch in New Vegas when we got jumped. Not even a drop your weapons and hands up before the bullets started flying. We put up a good fight, but there was too many of them. I took a few of the bandits down before I ran, so I figure their friends are out for revenge.
So it's not even like he's doing anything wrong. I mean, he's just sort of running away because he was blindsided, which is kind of sucky. So what is he going to do about the Powder Gangers?
I'm going to lay low for as long as I can, assuming the town doesn't throw me to the wolves. I've got no chance against the gang on my own.
You need a hired gun? I'm available.
All I've got left on me are a handful of caps. But you get me out of this, and I'll make sure the Crimson Caravan pays you back. You've got my word.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna do it.
We just end up sharing the same grave if it's just the two of us. Now, if some of the other people in town were also on board.
I'm definitely gonna ask around, see who I can round up. We gotta take these guys down.
Start with Sunny Smiles. She's been friendlier than most around here.
Alright, so we do get a little bit of... Actually, I'm just going to loot all this. First of all, we do get a little bit of advancement here with the Sunny asking us to go see Sunny Smiles and such. Let's see if there's anything good to loot here. A lot of Sunset Sarsaparilla, that's awesome. What's down here? Carton of Sigs. Ooh, ammo that I'd be stealing, so I'm not going to take it. I think I'm going to do a generally good run-through, good character run-through of this game, just because I'm nervous about... Yeah, if you don't do it nicely, then people get mad at you, and then I don't think I'll be in for a good time. Just sort of looking around here. I apologize. That's empty. I should be reading. Let's see. Turpentine. Detergent. What is this? Take boxing. That's probably... You get an increase in unarmed. Definitely taking the doctor's bag for sure. Okay, so let's go talk to Sunny Smiles if she's next on her quest. I'm actually kind of happy that we're helping this guy out now, and we'll get some good experience with our guns and shit. So let's go talk to Sunny Smiles. At least we'll have another hired gun, and she's semi-proven from what we've seen from her, at least, with the varmint rifle little ordeal and the killing of the... What were they? Were there geckos? Geckos in her farms, the Good Springs farms. Let's go talk to her. I mean, I could pick this lock up here, but I would lose karma for it. Even though it's very easy, it is a good experience, but I think I'm going to just do it normally like this. I'm just going to go in the front way next to, what's his name, Easy Pete, in front of the the saloon here. Let's go see if we can talk to Sunny. Hopefully she's still in here. I know she said she was trying to get back, because she'd missed something on the radio, I believe. But let's find out if she's there with her doggy. Let's go talk to her.
Hi there. Sticking around Good Springs for a while longer?
Yeah, actually, I'm kind of... I'm gonna help. I want to help him. You know, I might need yours, too.
Say no more. I'm in.
Wow, she was ready to go. Let's do it.
Joe Cobb talks about leaving us alone if we hand over Ringo. But I know his type. He and his friends will come after the town eventually. However, between you, me, and Ringo, we aren't exactly a force to be reckoned with. A lot of people around here look up to Trudy. If you could convince Trudy to join us, some of the folks in town might decide to help out as well. I know Easy Pete's got a stock of dynamite somewhere, and Chet just got a shipment of leather armor we could borrow. Talk to them as well. Finally, there's a good chance we'll all end up with extra holes in us. So if Doc Mitchell could cough up some extra stim packs, that'd be great.
Wow, so this is like a whole big collection quest here. Let's go talk to all three of those people. Let's see. Any ideas on how I could convince Trudy to join us?
A silver tongue would help. Convincing Trudy that we had a good plan to win the fight would also help.
Good. Okay, let's talk about Chet.
I don't think Giv is in Chet's vocabulary. Even with the town at stake, he'd still make you barter with him.
Well, that's pretty easy because I both have good speech and barter. So let's, what about Easy Pete?
Easy Pete's pretty protective of his dynamite. You'd have to convince him you know a thing or two about explosives before you handed it over.
Explosives might be a bit tough, but we're going to do as much as we can. Let's go talk to him.
I'll be waiting.
Okay, so we're slowly mounting a force. Like I said, I can't wait and see it, you know, who joins in.
So you're planning on taking on Joe Cobb's gang. It's a big risk, but I suppose you have to do what you think is right.
Okay, so let's talk to her here. We definitely can do the speech. Oh, we can't do the sneak one. That's fine. We'll do speech.
I was planning on sitting this one out, but for some reason, I can't help but like you. I'm with you. Let me have a word with a few other folks, and I'll see if I can't round up some more members for this militia you're creating. While everyone does own a gun, we could stand to be a little better equipped. The general store probably has what we need in stock.
Sweet. All right, so
Be careful out there.
We accepted and completed the speech option, which is good. Let's get out of here, talk to Easy Pete. I don't know if our explosions is quite good enough yet, so I'm kind of nervous to talk to him. I don't want to fail it, so I might back out of the conversation. I might have a magazine that helps with that, but this is the general store, correct? Let's go in here and see if they have exactly what we need, which would be very, very nice. Let's see. Let's go talk to this guy. Is this Chet? Oh, it is Chet. Let's talk to him.
You must be the one Doc Mitchell was patching up. The way I heard it, I didn't think you'd be walking out of that office. I've got plenty of supplies for sale. Even got some weapon mods and special ammo. Well worth the caps, if you ask me. If you're hurting for caps, I've also got boxes of surplus ammo in the miscellaneous section. They're not great, but you get what you pay for.
Let's actually see. What makes your super sound inferior? Okay, I think I'm okay with this. Let's actually. I want to see if he has any guns that we can grab really quickly. Look, he has boxing gloves, which is pretty cool. He got some dynamite. Another energy weapon, it looks like. A silence pistol, a throwing knife. A shovel to dig some graves up in the graveyard up there. But let's. I think I'm going to grab the. Is that a 22? Did it say a 22 pistol? Leather armor we can get from him through barter, I believe. So, I don't want any of that. Let's check for his ammo here. I don't really need any hollow point rounds. He only has one of each, though. These are really not that good. Oh, he doesn't have that many. Oh, he has 40 of them. They cost one each. Okay, that makes more sense to me. Okay, I'm definitely going to buy that. Let's buy some 22 LR rounds for our pistol. Okay, I'll be giving him 111 caps. That means I'm going to see if I can sell anything here. I'm going to get rid of that. Varmint rifle we don't really need. What about some of these things here? Boxing time's going to keep. I'm going to keep. That's what I meant. Let's see. Can give him one of these. What is that? Just I'm going to keep one just for the other guy for easy peat. I'm just checking if I have anything that I can give him that would be of worth. Ah, a carton of cigarettes, I guess, would be very good. So let's accept that, and let's talk to him about the supplies for the Powder Gangers.
Now just hold on. I never voted to take on the Powder Gangers. That's a 1,000 cap investment you're talking about.
Are you kidding me right now? I mean, I could try it, but I would fail. Let me never mind it really quick and see if I have anything for barter. Right. Let me see if I do have anything for barter. I'm going to check up in the vats really quick, see what I got as far as items go. I'm surprised I don't have something for that, actually. Do I have any? Oh, I do have barter. Let me take that. Let's talk to him.
You're
yes, I
buy
am.
Some supplies?
Accept us for this.
This again? Like I said, I'm against taking on the Powder Gangers. My supplies aren't cheap.
Alright, let's barter them now. Let me take over the town then. I'm sure your business will be much better off. Or let them take over the town.
You made your point. I can provide people with some leather armor and extra ammo. Sure hope it's worth it. And I'll be guarding the store while all this is going on. I have to put my business first. You understand.
Sweet. Awesome. So, it looks like we have 2 out of 3, I believe. Now, let's go see if we can grab Easy Pete here. It looks like all of the speech options and such like that are all, what was it, 25? So, let's go back and talk to Easy Pete. He's right here by the store. I don't know what all these other arrows are. I'm going to have to check that out in the vats when I get that. Let's go talk to Mr. Pete. Howdy. Yes, very much so. I've heard you got dynamite. I hear that you've got dynamite. Can help us beat the Powder Gangers.
Too dangerous. Gonna kill all yourselves if I let you touch it. Better to leave it buried. Safer that way.
So even if I take the plus 10 and explosives, I still would be short. I'm gonna never mind him really quickly and see what else I can do around here. Because I'm just not quite close to that yet. I wish I would have thought of that beforehand. Let's check on this quest, though, while we're at it. Where's the quest? There we go. Optional acquire. Okay, we can go to dock, and then. Okay, so returning to Ringo looks like that will be it. That means we'd have to start the quest. So let's go talk to Doc Mitchell and see if we can level up. That's really what I'm hoping for here, is getting just a quick level so that I can put 2 in new explosives. Although I don't feel like we're going to be very close. And I don't think you can stack magazines. It doesn't make sense to me. So I'm not too sure about doing that. But let's talk to Doc Mitchell anyway and see what he has to say about giving us his supplies. Because that would be really nice of him. And I don't think that he might need the increase in science. But I'm not sure. Let's go talk to him regardless. And hopefully we get kind of lucky or something like that.